Maricopa's scholarship fund receives a gift of $200,000. The money is invested in stocks, bonds, and CDs, where CDs pay 3.1% interest, bonds pay 4.25% interest, and stocks pay 8.2% interest. Maricopa Success invests $25,000 more in bonds than in stocks. If the annual income from the investments is $9,925, how much was invested in each account? So this is kind of a silly question because my answer would be, if you look at your statement, you could see how much was invested in each account. But this is often a common question when looking at applications involving systems of three equations with three unknowns. So let's go ahead and go through this. The first thing to recognize is that we have three different types of accounts that pay different interests. So let's define our variables where we'll let S equal the amount invested in stocks. We'll let B equal the amount invested in bonds, and we'll let C be equal to the amount invested in CDs. Let's also make a note that the CDs pay 3.1% interest, the bonds pay 4.25% interest, and the stocks pay 8.2% interest. Now let's begin to write our equations that will form the system of equations. Well, if we know that the gift is $200,000, that means S plus B plus C must equal 200,000. Next, we're told that they invest $25,000 more in bonds than in stocks. Since there's $25,000 more in bonds, if we want to write an equation using B and S, we can say B, the amount invested in bonds, would have to be equal to S, the amount invested in stocks, plus 25,000. Again, whatever is invested in stocks, or S, B, the amount invested in bonds, is going to be $25,000 more. And then finally, we're told the annual income from the investment is $9,925. And this is where the interest comes into play. If we multiply the interest by the amount invested in that account, it will give us the income from that investment. To find a percent of a number, we convert the percent to a decimal and multiply. So 8.2% is equivalent to 0.082. So we can say 0.082 times S. This will give us the income from the stocks, plus 0.0425 times B. This will give us the amount of income from the bonds, plus 0.031 times C, which is the amount of income from the CDs, must equal $9,925. So this is the system of equations that we need to solve for S, B, and C. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. So to begin, my suggestion might be to eliminate the decimals from this third equation. Notice how this term here has four decimal places. So if we multiply the entire equation by 10,000, we'll have an equivalent equation that does not contain decimals. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to multiply this equation by 10,000. So that would give us, this would be 820S plus, this would be 425B. Okay, we're multiplying each of these terms by 10,000, which is the same as moving the decimal point to the right four times. So we'd have plus, this would be 310C. And here we'd have to add four extra zeros, so 9,925,000. So this is 99,250,000. We'll leave the first two equations the same. So to solve this system, we want to form two equations with two unknowns, and then solve that system for one variable. To do this, we're going to perform a substitution. Looking at this last equation, notice how B is equal to S plus 25,000. So wherever we see a B, we can substitute S plus 25,000. So we'll make that substitution here for B in the first equation, and here for B in the second equation. This will give us two equations with just the variables S and C, which we can then solve for one of the variables using elimination or substitution. So looking at the first equation, we would have 820S plus 425 times S plus 25,000 plus 310C equals our constant here on the right. So we'd have 820s plus, this would be 425s, and 425 times 25,000 is 10,625,000. We have plus 310c equals our constant on the right. Let's go ahead and combine our like terms here, and then we'll subtract this constant on both sides of the equation. So that would give us 1,245s, and we still have plus 310c. Then when we subtract 10,625,000 on both sides, we would have 88,625,000. So this is one equation that has just s and c. And now we'll perform the substitution for b in the second equation, which would give us s plus s plus 25,000 plus c equals 200,000. So s plus s is 2s. We'll subtract 25,000 on both sides just a moment. So plus c equals, subtracting 25,000 on both sides will give us 175,000. So notice how equation 1 and now equation 2 contain both just s and c. And now we'll solve these two equations as a system for either s or c, and then perform back substitution to find the values of the remaining variables. So let's take equation 1 and 2 onto the next slide. So trying to solve this system, we could easily solve this for c and then perform substitution into equation 1, or we could multiply this equation here by negative 310 to add the equations together and eliminate c. Let's go ahead and solve this equation for c though and use substitution. So using equation 2, we can say that c is equal to 175,000 minus 2s. And now we're going to perform a substitution into equation 1. We're going to substitute this for this c here, which will give us an equation with just s. So 1,245s plus 310 times 175,000 minus 2s must equal 88,625,000. We'll distribute and then solve for s. So when we distribute, we'll have plus 54,250,000 minus 620s equals the right side. Combining the s terms, we would have 625s, and then we'll subtract 54,250,000 on both sides of the equation, giving us 34,375,000. And now finally, to solve for s, we'll divide both sides by 625. So we have S, the amount invested in stocks, equals $55,000. So now that we know S, we can perform back substitution to find C and B. Notice here we know that C is equal to 175,000 minus 2S. Let's find C. So we'd have minus 2 times 55,000 . So this would be 175,000 minus 110,000, which would give us 65,000. Which is the amount invested in CDs. And now to find B, we'll have to use an earlier equation. Let's go ahead and use this equation here, where b is equal to s plus 25,000. So if b is equal to s plus 25,000, and we now know s is 55,000, we'd have 55,000 plus 25,000, which should be $80,000. This is why it's so important to define the variables. Remember, S is the amount invested in stocks, C is the amount invested in CDs, and B is the amount invested in bonds. I hope you found this explanation helpful.